Not terribly long ago, I was speaking to a man who insisted that if you pray the right way, if you do the right things, if you have the right kind of faith, that God will make you rich. I said, really, what about all the passages in the Bible that talk about us suffering, identifying with Jesus, the Apostle Paul talking about a thorn in his flesh? What about those prevailing themes? Sure, the Bible does have a sort of consistent theme that seems to suggest that there are times and seasons that God may abundantly bless his children in order that they might be a blessing to others. But the idea that you can somehow have a formula of faith whereby God is obligated to make you wealthy and prosperity in this life, well, I just don't see that in the scripture. Well, this man is a very well-intentioned individual. He said back to me, what about Ephesians 1:7? I said, well, okay, let's take a look. So, Ephesians 1:7 is the verse for today. Here's what it says. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses according to the riches of his grace. Listen, this passage isn't telling you that you're going to get rich for following Jesus. In fact, it's saying something altogether different. How do you get rich because of Jesus? We, according to the riches of God the Son, can gain access because of the grace that is poured out in him into that truest of all forms of wealth. That is eternal life and having the presence of the holy living God, the Holy Spirit, take up residence inside of us. Listen, following Jesus may not make you rich. It may not even make your life a whole lot immediately better or easier in this world. But what following after Jesus Christ does is put us into the place of being loved as though we were the very children of God, because that's what we become by way of adoption. Listen, I want to encourage you today. Ephesians chapter 1 and verse 7. In him we have redemption through his blood. That is the wealth afforded to followers of Jesus Christ, to children, to those who have been saved because of the grace of God that is poured out and the gift of faith that allows us to access the power of the living God. Redemption. We're redeemed. We are beloved. God bless you today. Listen, whatever you're going through today, whether your pockets are full of cash or there's a penny way down in there, if you are alive in Jesus Christ, then you and I have all of the wealth that has been given to us in the beloved. You're loved today, and that is the greatest wealth that anyone can possess. God bless you today. Amen.